Our verse today is Mark chapter 2, verse 6. Now some of the scribes were sitting there questioning in their hearts. This verse comes from the story of the healing of a certain paralytic. Four men carried this man who had paralysis. As they could not find a way to enter the house where Jesus was, they opened part of the roof and lowered the man down into the place. Jesus was impressed by their faith and said to the man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." This utterance of Jesus did not go down well with the scribes listening to Jesus. Do not forget that the scribes were the learned men who studied the Torah, that is the law of Moses. They were the experts. They immediately faltered what Jesus said. They knew that only God could forgive sins, and Jesus was making a humongous claim. And this was tantamount to blasphemy. And they were right, because Jesus was taking the place of God. And the law says, whoever blasphemes the name of the Lord shall surely be put to death. Leviticus 24 verse 16. Jesus knew they were uncomfortable and raised questions in their hearts, and then responded that the Son of Man has the authority to forgive sins. In other words, he was implicitly saying to them that he is God. Our interest today in this verse is what was going on in the hearts of the scribes. Our translation says they were questioning in their hearts. The Greek word in the text is dialogizomai, which means to think through something thoroughly, consider carefully, and reason out something inwardly. It also means to discuss or argue or debate with someone. But on this occasion, they were thinking inwardly about what Jesus had said and what to do to Jesus. One thing that would have been clear to them is that Jesus was guilty of blasphemy, which is punishable by death. How does this verse speak to us today? What occupies our hearts most times? How do we see and evaluate people's words and actions? Do we see them from only one point of view without considering other sides? The scribes knew the law, but could not see that Jesus was the Messiah, the expected Savior. Sometimes we can be blind to the truth about some people because we focus only on the negatives. Do you have good thoughts and intentions towards people with different opinions? It is surprising sometimes to see Christians wishing people dead because they share different faith or hold contrary opinions. Do you see the good in other people's actions? Or are you often thinking of reasons to discredit or condemn the good they have done? The scribes were thinking of how to discredit Jesus, and that he had no power to forgive sins. Let us ask God today for the grace not to be judgmental, but to learn to listen carefully and discern properly before making judgments. Lord, help us to see the good in people, value what they say to us, and think through what they say before making judgments. Amen. God bless you, and I wish you a pleasant day.